you know, being successful at things is owning who you are and knowing what you can and can't do.
My name is Buck Doyle. I am 52 years old. In my previous work or my life, I just spent 21 and a half years in the Marine Corps. In the Marine Corps, I was able to, and fortunate enough to stay in the reconnaissance field, so the special operations community. After I retired in 2010, another opportunity came about and I was able to contract for the Pentagon, and I was an advisor. Kind of wrapped things up with that job in 2014 and started doing what I'm doing now, and is consulting and teaching. I probably spend 70% of my time building and setting up the range or courses of fire. And I'll probably spend the rest of that 30% of time shooting. I want the shooter to experience everything, just not pressing that trigger and hearing an explosion and hearing that ping, but the whole everything, the situational awareness. We talk about that all the time in training. I want them to experience that. My favorite part of teaching is watching the shooter or the student, watching their reaction when that light bulb comes on. And then what once is understanding of what's being taught, the real questions start coming. Because now your student or shooter is very enthused about what just happened and wants to build on that.
Go ahead and get on your first target. Again, mill it out. You should mill out 0.8 mils on that 12 inches.
One of the big misconceptions is that I teach long range. They think, oh, he's teaching long range or sniper class. I mean, that's far from being exact about what I teach. What I teach is gunfighting. Man on a mission, I'm a kid, and you know I be on a what? Yeah. You know I be on a what? Man on a mission, I'm a kid, and you know I be on a what? Yeah. It's all hard, ain't no fear here. You ain't giving this to all, you steer clear. I'm on the way. On the way. I'm on the way. After retiring and then getting into the firearms training, you start dealing with other people. And then, you know, for me, it was the film industry. And I started finding myself being approached by actors, directors, producers, and they were asking, hey, what makes a guy do this? Or what does this firearm do this? Why? And the next thing you know, I'm on set assisting with the project. Yeah, something I thought I'd never want to get involved with, but I fell in love with really quick because it was work. It was unknown territory, and at the same time, I was learning a lot.
Probably the toughest obstacle I had to overcome is after I got shot. I got shot and there was some nerve damage and not knowing whether or not I was gonna be that guy again. You take on a occupation or job or lifestyle that has that inherent risk. No matter how good you get, you're always, you can be subjected to falling to those risks. And I think a lot of people don't think about it. I don't care, get any ball players, pilots, whatnot. No one thinks about the risks fully that come with that living that lifestyle. And I think when you do come across those risks and they impact your life, that is one hell of a decision to make whether or not you continue that lifestyle. And that's gotta be the hardest thing. There's really nothing you can do about that other than get back out there and do it again, or get back in that arena. At least you know whether or not you're still that guy. And I was very fortunate that it was.
That big scar is surgery. The actual bullet hole is about that big, going in and out. My whole bottom of my arms is blown out.
So now when I hunt and hit a deer or whatnot, it's always cool to look at the entrance wound and exit wound and compare it.
Fortunately, everything went fine, and I was back in Afghanistan 16 months later. And I can remember distinctly, we were doing a patrol. We hit an IED, blew the whole front of the truck out. I wiggled my toes, my fingers, I looked at my driver. He was looking at me like, what the heck? I looked at the gunner, he was like, I'm okay. And then everything was back to normal. I was like, I got this. After the explosions, I was rattling off the report for explosion. I was talking back to the guys. I was telling them, hey, we gotta do this. So things were naturally just kicking in, and there's this huge weight lifted off me. It was that incident that let me know that, hey, you still got it.
When you fail, you just gotta take it and learn from it and keep on moving. I think a lot of people don't understand that with a lot of success in life, whether it be with relationships, your job, anything, you're gonna fail. And when you get to the end point or that finish line, you're gonna look back on your failures and how you overcame them. I don't wish for failure, but there is a benefit to it. And I think the benefit outweighs just flawlessly going through things in life without learning from those hardships or challenges.